Good day, children. Sai Ram. How are you all? Today, in Value Education, I am going to start with a new chapter. Chapter number 4. Gyani Dadaji is going to tell us a mythological story. That is Bhakta Dhruva. It's about Bhakta Dhruva. Dhruva was a son of Suniti and Uttanapada. King Uttanapada had another wife named Suruchi. She had a son named Uttama. Dhruva and Uttama loved each other very much. So King Uttanapada had two wives. One was Suniti and the other one was Suruchi. Suniti had a son named Dhruva and Suruchi also had a son named Uttama. Okay. So King Uttanapada had two sons. One was Dhruva and other one was Uttama. Dhruva was the eldest son and Uttama was the youngest one. Dhruva and Uttama loved each other very much. They used to play, enjoy together. Mother, father is free. May I go and sit in his lap? So, Uttama asked his mother, Suruchi, that father is free, sitting free. So, can I go and sit on his lap? Certainly, my son, it is your rightful place as you are the future king. Then his mother, Suruchi, replied that, yes, why not? You can go and sit because that is only your rightful place as you are the future king. So, when you grow up, you will be the king. So you can go and sit on your father's lap. That is Suruchi told Uttama. And he went and sat on his father's lap. When Dhruva saw Uttama sitting in his father's lap, he also ran towards them. So Dhruva came over there and he saw that Uttama, his brother, is sitting on his father's lap. So he also felt like going and sitting on his father's lap. And so he started running towards his father. I too will sit on my father's lap, Dhruva said. Then Dhruva ran towards his father and he told that, I too will sit on my father's lap. Certainly not. You have no right to be there. Go away. Suruchi told Dhruva that, no, you don't have right to be there here. Come and sit on your father's lap. You go away from here. Where shall I go, mother? Then he asked Suruchi that, where shall I go? Then what did Suruchi reply? Go to Lord Narayana. Seek his blessings to be reborn as my son. Then only you can have the same rights like Uttama. Then what did Suruchi tell Dhruva? That go to Lord Narayana and take his blessings to be reborn as my son. Then only you can have the same rights like Uttama has. Now this poor child Dhruva was hurt. He ran to his mother Suniti crying. So he was hurted. So he went to his mother crying. Why are you crying, my son? So his mummy Suniti asked Dhruva that, why are you crying? Then Dhruva is answering, mother, Suruchi said, I have no right to sit on my father's lap. Only Uttama has a right. Then he told his mother that mother Suruchi had said her that he has no right to sit on his father's lap. Only Uttama has the right. Why is it so? Then Suniti told that she is right, my child. Then Suniti told Dhruva that she is right. Now Dhruva became calm and thoughtful. Then Dhruva became quiet and was thinking. Mother Suruchi also told me to seek Lord Narayana's blessings. If I want to sit on my father's lap, will Narayana really help me, mother? Then Dhruva is asking his mother that, Suniti that Mother Suruchi has told me to take seek Lord Narayana's blessing if I want to sit on my father's lap. So will Narayana really help me? That is, he asked. Dhruv asked his mother. Then what did his mother reply? Yes, my child, he never fails those who turn to him. Then his mother told that, yes, my child, he will bless you. So those who go to him, he always bless them. So she told, yes, my child, he never fails those who turn to him. Okay. Then I shall find him out. Then Dhruv said that, then I shall go and find him out where he is. Go, my son, he is the only refugee. He can only help us. It will be difficult for you to find him, but if you try hard, you will succeed. Then his mother said, Suniti said that, yes, he can only help us. So, but it is very difficult to find him. We don't know where he is. So, you have to try your best and you will succeed. Okay. I will not return unless and until I find Lord Narayana. He will bless me to become a greater king than my father. So, he ran to in search of Lord Narayana. Then he told that, I will not return unless and until I find Lord Narayana. He will bless me to become the greater king than my father. And he went away. Meanwhile, Narada met Dhruv. So, on the way, Narad Muni met Dhruv. Why are you here, my child? Then he asked Dhruv that, why are you here? Dhruv replied, I want to win Lord Narayana's favor. Then Dhruv told Narada that, I want to win Lord Narayana's favor. I am aware of that, my child, but you are too young. It is not so easy to find Lord Narayana. Why don't you wait till you are a little older? Then Narada said that, I know why you have come here, but child, you are too young, you are so small. It is not so easy to find Lord Narayana. You please wait till you are a little older. Okay. Oh, wise one, I will not turn back. Tell me how I can succeed in my resolve. So he told that, yes, I know you want me to go back to the palace, but I will not turn back. Now you are going to tell me that how can I succeed in my resolve. If you meditate in Madhuban forest on the banks of the river Yamuna, you will find the Lord. Then Narada told Dhruv that if you meditate, if you do Naam Jap, okay, in the Madhuban forest on the banks of the river Yamuna, you will find the Lord. Oh sage, let me how to meditate. Then Dhruv asked Narada that, please tell me how to meditate. Then Narada, he explained how to meditate. Repeat, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Chant this name continuously with concentration. So he told that you have to chant Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya continuously with concentration. Then again Dhruv repeated, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Dhruv reached Madhuban. So he reached Madhuban. I shall sit here and meditate. Then he found a tree and he said that, now I will sit here and meditate. For some time, Dhruv lived only on fruits, then only on grass and leaves. Later, he lived only on water. Slowly, he started living on air. So, what happened, you know? Through first beginning, he lived only on fruits. Okay. And then, after that, he ate only grass and leaves. First, he ate only fruits. Okay. Then, he ate only grass and leaves. Later on, afterwards, he lived only on water. He drank only water. No fruits, no grass, no leaves. He drank only water. Slowly, he started living on air. So, slowly, he didn't eat fruits, no grass, no leaves, and no water also. So, slowly, he started living on air. And he started meditating. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Lord Narayana appeared in front of him. So at last, Lord Narayana appeared in front of him. And he asked Dhruv, "What has brought you to this place, my child?" Then Lord Narayana asked Dhruv that, "Why have you come here?" "Oh Lord, I want a permanent place from where nobody can drive me away." So Dhruv said that, "I want a permanent place from where no one can drive me away. No one can tell me to go away." "You shall have a place in heaven where you shall stay forever. Go back. You shall also rule the kingdom for a long time." Then Lord Narayana blessed him and told him that, "You shall have a place in heaven where you shall stay forever. Okay, go back. You shall also rule the kingdom for a long time." Means you'll become the king and you'll get a place. Also, you'll get a place in heaven that from there no one will tell you to go away. Okay, so you shall stay for over there. Okay, then Lord Narayana disappeared. Again, Dhruv started chanting, "Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya." Thus, Dhruv became the pole star, means Dhruv Nakshatra. The other name for pole star is Dhruv Nakshatra in the sky. The other seven stars of the seven rishis can also be seen slowly moving around the pole star. So thus Lord Narayana blessed Dhruv and Dhruv became the pole star, that is Dhruv Nakshatra in the sky. The other seven stars of the seven rishis, you know who are the other seven rishis? Do you know that? Sapta rishis. Do you know the name? Other seven rishis? Don't know. I will tell you. Okay, listen carefully. Rishi Kashyap, Rishi Atri, Rishi Vasishtha, Rishi Vishwamitra, Rishi Gautam, and Rishi Jamdagni, and Rishi Bharadwaj. These are the seven rishis. So, the other seven stars of the seven rishis can also be seen slowly moving around the pole star. Okay. What is the moral of the story? Anything can be achieved by faith and firm determination. Moral is, anything can be achieved by faith and firm determination. If you want to achieve something in your life, you should have faith and firm determination. Okay, children, we have ended with our today's period. We'll meet in the next period with the textbook activity. Thank you. Have a good day.